But I have to tell you, for actors, you have to understand how this works. Is that, see, very rarely does an actor go off a job or finish something and have a sense that they're actually going to work again. Okay? Most actors, really, you finish one project, you never know when you're going to work again. It can be 6 months, 9 months, a year, no matter what you've done, people ask, what are you doing now? Nothing, you know, or I'm waiting for this, or I'm going to do this, or
got
that.
A few pokers in the fire.
It's very hard to really justify to anybody, but when you have a series that's picked up, and you know you're going to come back in 6 months, and you can go have some fun, enjoy yourself, and know that there's going to be a paycheck coming back in, and that you can actually tell people you're actually working on a show, that feels so good, and it's such a rare thing in this industry for most of us actors. So for me, it was more than just, oh God, we're out of a job again. We're back in line. We're now having to go out and audition and try to get through the pipeline and to find that next job. And even though you start on a show, it doesn't really matter. I mean, there's so many people wanting jobs that when you finish a job, you never know where the next paycheck is coming from. So it kind of hits you on all cylinders. Yeah.
Richard, what was your reaction when you found out that Rick Springfield was going to be your brother?
I was a little pissed off. Are you kidding me? That little, God, who the hell does he think? Who the frack does he think he is? You know, Rick, I have to be honest with you. I don't know why they took him off, you know, because, you know, he would have been the pinup boy on all those 16 magazines instead of me and Dirk, you know. But I like the fact of having a brother. I actually like that idea, so I wish they had left him on the show. And I'm sure that they kind of kicked their butt when he got onto General Hospital, became famous after that, and then went out and did his music and his career took off. And, you know, all that stuff. I'm sure they wish they had him on the show. But you know, the funny part is, I remember Rick when he was a solo act, before he had the band, the guitar, and they were trying to make him into this pop star. I remember seeing him on American Bandstand or something, thinking, oh, this guy's never, you know, I just thought, he's never gonna make it. But I really liked Rick when he came on the show. He had a great way about him, very down to earth, very genuine, and very fun, and I liked to sing him when he got into the band and started doing all those. By the way, I just saw him in Denver. Concert, you know, singing Jesse's Girl. Yeah. He's gonna pull the plug on us.
Well, actually, the Next Generation panel is about to start, so let's wrap it up with just a couple more quick questions. Yes.